Good morning, class 9. We'll be starting today again the new topic in the same chapter. Yesterday we started the new chapter, that is digestive system, chapter number 11. Okay, so far in this chapter we have learned till mouth, I think we were discussing about where we discuss about the tongue, about the lips, and then different type of teeth. And today we'll be learning about dental formula and the structure of the tooth. And then we'll try to complete the topic salivary gland also. Okay. Now see, about the dental formula. Dental formula is usually written counting the number of incisors, canines, or premolar, molar in the half of the lower and upper jaw. Okay, need to remember how. Now see, in human child, in the lower jaw, there are 4 incisors. Okay, now if you make it half, then it will be 2. Okay, so the upper number represents the number of teeth present in the half of the upper jaw, and the lower one represents the number of teeth present in the lower jaw. For the half of the lower jaw. So in the half of the upper jaw, in children, 2 incisors are present. So while writing dental formula, so first we'll write the incisor. Then again, in the half of the upper jaw, in upper jaw 2 canines are present. So in half, 1 canine will be present. And in human child, there is no premolar, so 0. Then again, if you talk about the molar, okay, there are total 4 molar in the upper jaw. So in the half jaw, only 2 molar we find. So that is why in the upper jaw, while writing the dental formula, what we do? We write 2 incisors, 1 canine, 0 premolar and 2 molar. Then again, in the lower jaw, 4 incisors are present. So that is why in the half of the lower jaw, 2 incisors. In the half of the lower jaw, 1 canine, and again 0 premolar and 2 molar. Now same if we talk about the human adolescent. Okay, one more point. If you count total, see 4 incisor, 2 canine, then again 4 premolar. Okay, double it will come equal to 20. Okay, so total number of teeth that is present in human child is 20, which is the milk teeth. Okay, then again human adolescent. Okay, in human adolescent, in upper jaw, half of the upper jaw, 2 incisor is present. Then again, 1 canine, and then 2 premolar and 2 molar. Okay. Then again, in the lower jaw, same way, 2, 1, 2, 2. Okay. So 2 plus 2 is 4, 4 plus 2 is 6. 6 plus 1 is 7. So 7 double it, it will be 14, and down also 7 double it, it will be 14, 14 plus 14, it will come equal to 28. So total number of teeth in human adolescent is 28. Okay, same way in human adult, okay, in the upper jaw, half of the upper jaw, 2 incisor, 1 canine, 2 premolar and 3 molar, because in the adult, wisdom teeth is also developed. Okay, so that is why 2 wisdom teeth is developed in each of the jaw. So half, in half only 1 wisdom teeth we can count. So total it makes how much? 32. So this way we can write the dental formula. So while writing the dental formula, first we write the incisor, then canine, then premolar, then molar. Okay, so this numerator one, the number in the numerator one shows the number of teeth present in the half of the upper jaw, and the down one represents the number of teeth present in the half of the lower jaw. Okay, so this is about the dental formula. Now again, next comes the structure of tooth. Okay, so externally a tooth can be of three, like can be divided into three distinct regions, that is crown, neck and root. Okay, externally tooth can be divided into three distinct regions, that is crown, neck and root, as you can see in the figure also. Okay, crown, which is the visible part. Okay, root, which is the part deep inside the present deep inside the what you call jaw socket. okay, where the tooth is firmly fixed. Okay, root, crown, and the region between these crown and root is what you call the neck. Now, we'll discuss about the internal structure also. So, internally, tooth can be divided into four different parts: enamel, dentine, cement, pulp cavity. Okay, so four different structure is shows. Enamel, which is considered to be the hardest bone in the human body. Okay, the whitish side, outermost layer of the crown. Then again, inner to enamel, the another layer is present, which we call as the dentine. Okay, dentine, then again inner to dentine, the cavity is present, which we call as the pulp cavity. This pulp cavity is highly supplied with blood capillaries, lymph. Okay, so this is there. Then again, after that comes the cement. Cement is the structure which fixes the tooth firmly to the root of, or to the inside the socket of the jaw. Okay, so this is there. So this is about the internal structure of tooth. Okay, about the premolar and molar also structure is given, that also you require to draw. This also practice, please draw in your copy. Okay, now after that comes, so we completed the different types of teeth and all about the mouth. Now one more topic is present under this topic, mouth, that is salivary gland. Salivary gland are usually of three different types. Okay, starting from parotid salivary gland, sublingual, submandibular, then sublingual. Okay, so three different types of salivary glands are present, which opens into the mouth. Then after that, the fluid is secreted, which is secreted by the salivary gland, is what you call the saliva. Now you need to